Let's beat the team. At the power forward position, at 6'3", number 32, Cheyenne Parker. Starting at center, standing 6'5", number 31, Stephanie Dolson. Starting at shooting guard, 5'10", number 14, Ellie Quigley. At point guard, 5'8", number 22, Courtney Vandersloot. At small forward, 6'1", number 1, Diamond DeShields. A head coach for your team. Ladies and gentlemen, your Chicago Sky.
Hello and welcome. It's the WNBA here on 2K Sports. And tonight, it'll be the Atlanta Dream going up against the Chicago Sky. Alongside Tim Swartz and Brian Vanapetemi, I'm Blake Suniga. Thanks for joining us. And tonight, two teams that use rebounding to try to control the game. Now, Tim, talk about the importance of boxing out in this one.
Whoever wins the rebounding battle probably will win the game. Remember, when you get an O board specifically, the defense isn't organized, and it can lead to some easy hoops.
And don't get caught up ball watching. You know, you want to find your opponent, box them out, and know that it's going to be a battle. So, to me, the tougher team is going to have the edge in tonight's game.
Now, here is McCautry. Good work defensively by Stephanie Dolson. Here's DeShields. That kick out to Quigley. Six on the shot clock. From outside the arc, the shot comes out, and the Dream going the other way now. And Tiffany Hayes, here we go. And that comes off the assist by Renee Montgomery.
An unselfish, solid passer. Montgomery is always looking for the open teammate, and that's what I love about her game.
Now here's DeShields. Pass to Quigley. Back to DeShields. The three. Diamond DeShields can't get that one to fall.
Still scoreless after four attempts, trying to take the lid off, and it's not always easy.
Montgomery, Vandersloot defending. And here's Williams. Here's McCautry. And it's Dolson with the rebound.
As far as, you know, a jumper will go, that's as high percentage as it gets.
Seriously, I don't know how that one didn't fall.
Yeah, late reaction for the defense. She's always going to convert that.
Pass to Hayes. Here's Breland, guarded by Quigley. Breland with the bucket.
Sets the tone with physical and focused play. Breland is her team's spark plug.
And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. Now here's Vandersloot. Montgomery covering. Vandersloot outside. Pass to Quigley. Dolson. Parker. He's guarded by Hayes. Vandersloot, no good. And there's the foul. It'll go on Stephanie Dolson. That is her first foul of the game. Now about 3 minutes gone in the first quarter. Pass to McCautry. Montgomery. Up top, Williams. Shot clock at 5. Here's McCautry.
I admire the defensive mentality that Parker plays with each and every game.
And here is Vandersloot. Breland defending. Vandersloot outside. Poked away. Here's Parker. Jessica Breland comes up with the rebound.
Well, good defense in the paint. Worth its weight in gold.
It absolutely is. And we just saw it right there, didn't we? Without her presence, that's an easy 2 points.
Now here's Vandersloot. She hasn't yet put up any points in this one. To the wing on the left. She's off on that one. Great D that time from Elizabeth Williams.
Well, when you think of the best point guards in the league, Vandersloot has got to be right up there. And if you don't believe me, guys, just look at her assist numbers over the years.
And thinking of Vandersloot's success as a floor general, I think it stems from her top-tier awareness.
Yeah, she's always had a tremendous feel for the game. Reads defenses beautifully and makes plays accordingly. With great chemistry, Courtney and her teammates sync well on the court.
And the first one drops, and we see it all too often, Tim. A good team gets up for a big game, gets the win, and then loses to an inferior club the very next night.
But really, Blake, what is a quote-unquote inferior team? These are the best players in the world. Sure, some teams do have worse records. However, on any night, any team can step up.
Yeah, and the season is a grind. You know, head coaches always tell me their biggest challenge is keeping your team locked in. And if you're not 100% locked in, good luck beating anyone. I mean, even the lower teams in the WNBA.
Now here's Montgomery. Quiet so far offensively, searching for her first points of the game. From downtown, McCautry no good.
She just has not been able to make anything this quarter.
Parker, yes, and it's Allie Quigley picking up the assist.
Even for a player like Quigley, who is known for her ability to score, you have someone that open, you can't miss her.
Montgomery outside. Tiffany Hayes for three. Good on the three-point shot.
I tell you, she loves getting looks like that from three-point range. Just nobody near her.
Pass to Dolson. Vandersloot, Montgomery covering. Now here's Vandersloot. Not a lot of room. Gets that one to fall after missing her first two. 1 for 3 from the field. Now Montgomery. Pass to Breland. Outside Hayes. Here's Williams. Good work defensively by Stephanie Dolson. Parker with the ball. Montgomery covering. Out to Vandersloot. Parker. Now Dolson. Outside to Shields. Pass to Quigley. Let's it go from deep. That's in. She's got 2 made now, and she's shooting 2 for 3.
When a shooter like Quigley gets one off the pass, it allows him to feel comfortable, increasing the probability of a make.
And the dream call time here.
Well, for the Sky, the problem pretty easy to pick out. Just not a lot of tough defenders on this roster. Games they lose, they usually give up just too many easy buckets. We'll be right back.
both teams making substitutions here. Here's Coffee. Back to Williams. Bentley. Pass to Coffee. Clock at 6 from 13. And she hits the jumper for 2.
They can't afford to give her that kind of look.
Well, it came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you have to fight over the top of it.
And you need some help as well.
Now here's Williams. Now here is Sykes. She's guarded by Williams.
Nearly got a finger to that shot in the block attempt.
It was just as effective as a block. Made her completely change her release point and caused the miss.
Williams with it. She's guarded by Sykes. And here is Bentley. Pass to Coffee. Sykes. Now Williams. She's guarded by Williams. Now here is Bentley. Just 5 to shoot. There's the 3. And the Dream, another 3.
About a 30% three-point shooter. Bentley's three-point shooting isn't really one of her best attributes, but it's something you still have to respect.
Pass to Samuelson. Lavender with it. Outside Williams. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot and will go to the line.
Well, probably the right play defensively. If you can't get the block, send them to the line.
Exactly. You want to prevent the layup, give them a little knock, and then maybe they'll think twice about coming down the lane the next time around.
It does send a message.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
That free throw missing.
And for Atlanta, they're still looking for that first title. Remember, they lost in the finals 3 times now, and it's really not an easy hill to get over.
And no luck that time either. And for the Dream, it shows the sustained success of the franchise.
Yeah, I'm not a big participation trophy guy, Blake, but losing in 3 finals means you at least got to 3 finals, and how many teams can say that, right? But look, at the end of the day, it stings that they were swept out of all of those appearances, but I still feel like this team is on the verge of greatness.
Free throw is good.
Well, guys, it's always inspiring to see players like Sykes excel after enduring major injuries. Sykes had 2 just 10 months apart, but she rehabbed and she got back to playing great basketball.
And so she hits both. And thinking beyond what Sykes' injuries did to her on the court, she learned a lot of off the court as well.
No doubt. She learned maturity and patience during her tough times recovering. And after her character was put to the test, she became much more mentally strong. And I think the injury helped Brittany become who she really is.
Here's Copper, looking for her first basket still in this one.
If she can get to the rim, she'll usually turn it into points, but the defense stood tall there.
And that'll be Atlanta's ball as it goes out of bounds. Dream able to keep the ball here. Here's Bentley. Rebounded by Copper. The Sky Trail. shot to stop the drought. And a foul on the shot. She'll go to the stripe for two. It's going to go on Alex Bentley.
And what can you say about the playmaking of Courtney Vandersloot? Fantastic vision, fantastic passing ability, consistently near the top of the assist board in the WNBA. Easily one of the best passers this league has ever seen.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And she makes the first. And with Vandersloot, she draws comparisons to a player from her alma mater, John Stockton.
And the play style and approach is evident between the two guys. Stockton himself has said that Vandersloot has that special it factor about her, and she just has that ability to see the game. And I gotta say, she's the driving engine on this Chicago Sky team, to say the least.
And that's good as she hits both shots.
You see, for the Dream, the problem in games is rarely their defense. In fact, they're usually very strong on that end of the court. And I would say when they lose, it's more because their offense comes up short.
Here's Copper, defended by Bentley. Over to the wing, shot clock at six. Pass to Copper. Williams. Good D by Alex Bentley.
They haven't wasted any time getting into the swing of things on the boards.
And even this early, that's a good omen for the rest of the game.
Here's Gulich. No scoring yet from her, but that's likely to change. Sykes with the ball. Shoots a three. Quarter in the books, and it's been a close one. It's the Dream. They lead by a bucket. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break. And the second quarter getting underway. No team gaining an edge so far. And looking at what we've seen from the Dream, what do you guys think?
I like what I've seen from them defensively. They forced a lot of turnovers with quick hands.
Yeah, they've been aggressive. Those active hands producing steals early.
Now here's Lavender. She was fouled on the way up. Two free throws for her.
Well, you look at the strengths of this Atlanta Dream team, and it starts with Tiffany Hayes, pairing her up with McCautry, the clear core of the Dream.
And this is her first free throw of the game.
Shooting two.
And she knocks down the first one. As you said, the wing pair of Hayes and McCautry make for a fearsome duo.
Yeah, the team looks so dangerous when both are healthy and on the floor. And these two just provide so much in terms of playmaking and rebounding. And they're as talented a wing pair as we have in the entire league.
And she ties it up. Big free throw right there. Here's Bentley. To Sykes. Just five on the clock. They're tussling for it, and it looks like a jump ball. Chicago with the ball. On offense, here are the Sky. Here's Copper. The kick out to Williams. Down to five on the shot clock. And the go-ahead bucket, no good.
Well, got it in close, but credit the tight defense for forcing the miss.
Defense like that ups the degree of difficulty on that shot by about what? I'd say 300%?
308% maybe.
Okay, I like that.
Now here's Williams. She hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Copper, defended by Bentley. Here's Copper, off target at the rim. We're now around a minute and a half into the second quarter. 2 points, that one goes in.
Well, here in the second, they're showing some signs of life offensively.
Yeah, steadying themselves after a really tough first quarter. They're on the right track.
Now here's Williams, pass to Lavender. Fades away, the shot is good off the backboard.
Next time she has that much space, she should just go straight up with it and leave the fadeaway at home.
Hey, I'm right here.
Sykes outside. Got a piece of it. Bentley. Pass to Billings. Over Lavender. Gulich. The shot off that time. So Chicago will take it the other way. Here's Williams. Copper, defended by Bentley. Here's Endor. Outside Williams. The three is up. It's rebounded by Atlanta.
That's fantastic defense on one of the best three-point shooters in the league. Didn't give her an inch of room.
And that's the only way to stop her. The defender has to be all over her with a hand right in her face.
Here's Copper. Timeout called the Sky.
Yeah, the coaches seeing a lot of their shots miss the mark and figured it'd be a good time to draw something up, maybe get an easy look.
Yeah, all my coaches always had one go-to play that you just keep in your back pocket, and that's probably the one that the coach is drawing up here, trying to get their team an easy bucket out of this break.
Getting ready for the dream. Atlanta on D. They lead by four. Dolson in the post. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for her.
You know, bigs like Dolson, who can score from the perimeter, continue to rise in popularity. Empowered by her good shooting form, Stephanie is capable of really extending the floor, spreading the floor.
Now here's DeShields. And the layup's good off the glass.
Showing some physicality on that play. DeShields is terrific at finishing through contact.
Pass to Hayes. Here's Gulich. Here's McCautry. And that one off the back of the rim and in. And guys, just because Dolson can shoot the rock, don't think she can't rebound with the best of them.
Yeah, she's got great size and strength that allow her to get physical when she wants to. And she just plays with a lot of energy. And as a defender, it's hard to keep her away from the ball.
Here's Hayes. A rebound by DeShields. The Sky trail. Pass to Vandersloot. And here's Parker. Back to Vandersloot. Now here's DeShields. She's guarded by Hayes. Six to shoot. Here's Golson. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
The mobility of Golson coupled with her size, it's very difficult once she gets inside to stop. Sometimes you have to foul.
And it's her first trip to the line.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first free throw is good.
2017 was a breakout year for Stephanie Golson. She shot 56% from the field, 44% from three-point land, and averaged almost 15 per game, making her second All-Star team.
She's perfect from the line this time.
Well, a lot of young talent on the Chicago Sky team. Diamond DeShields and Gabby Williams are just two of their big names.
Now here is McCautry. Outside Hayes. Over Parker. Doesn't get it to drop for her. So Chicago will take it the other way. And all the names you mentioned for the Sky, very high draft pick.
The Sky has been trading for draft picks recently. They knew this rebuild was coming, doing it the right way, collecting talent over time. Eventually, they'll find another big name to add to the roster when the youth movement matures.
Now here is McCautry. Montgomery outside. Good work defensively by Stephanie Golson. Parker. No good. That would have tied it. McCautry left side. Got it. Good job in the low post.
A do-it-all offensive talent with top-shelf focus and work ethic. McCautry's truly made a name for herself in this league.
Now here is Golson. Quigley gets the bucket.
That's the type of lead pass we've really come to expect from her.
Atlanta in the lead.
Hey, yo, right here.
Montgomery outside. McCautry up top.
Yo, watch it, watch it.
Back to Montgomery. Good, and the assist goes to Angel McCautry.
A focal point of opposing game plans. McCautry just wants to find the open teammate. She's a willing distributor.
Now here's Vandersloot. To the middle. Tipped. And that's out of bounds. Chicago will retain possession.
So close to picking that pass off.
Still a nice play, though, to make sure the pass didn't reach the target.
Chicago with the ball. Trailing by four. Shot clock at six. The Shields.
There's no way around it. It's been a difficult game for her offensively, and it has cost her team.
Pass to Montgomery. Here's Hayes. Vandersloot defending. Tries it from 19. Chicago with the rebound.
Well, she didn't have a hand in her face, so I thought she was for sure going to bury that.
Up top to Shields. Reeland defending. Outside Quigley. Softly drops in the floater.
Strong float game from Quigley, and that's what separates her from other players labeled as shooters. She can hit hard shots like that.
Now here is Breland. Pass to Williams. Up again. It's good on the putbacks.
The rebound battle split about evenly.
Yeah, neck and neck on the glass. Just one aspect of what's been a very closely contested ball game.
And we love the close games.
Absolutely.
Here's Vandersloot. Soft touch off the glass.
If you poll WNBA coaches, Vandersloot might be the top choice to ball handle in the pick and roll. Great handles and decision making.
Now here's Montgomery. The lead is two. For three, Tiffany Hayes. That shot off. The sky go the other way with it.
You know, it's not been the best quarter for her as far as scoring. We'll see if she can get back on track.
If they could end every possession with that shot, they'd be happy, because 9 times out of 10, that's an easy layup.
Here's Hayes. She's got five.
Roger.
And so she draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two. That one on Quigley.
Doesn't want to be famous, but just respected. And I think Hayes really has that it factor.
Two shots.
The first one falls.
You know, I think Hayes still doesn't get the credit for how good she is. An underrated talent. Hayes makes a good team a great team. She doesn't care about being famous, just wants to be respected for balling.
Doesn't get the second. Yeah, I think you're completely right. When you think of her abilities, she's the perfect role player.
Yeah, Tiffany serves as the eternal sidekick, you know, the perfect centerpiece for a team. And it's easy to understand why you win games with Hayes. She's just different. That's how to orchestrate for your teammate. Terrific pass.
Pass to DeShields. Goes back up. She can't hit that time. Great D that time from Elizabeth Williams.
Yeah, I mean, she has been way off the mark this quarter. It is getting rough.
They get it back. Here's Billings. She's now 1 for 2 with that bucket.
Yeah, well, with eagle-eyed vision, Hayes has earned a reputation as a capable distributor.
Outside Quigley. Lavender outside. Good.
Ran her defender straight into that screen to open up the lane to the hoop.
And Atlanta has possession. 3-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Outside Bentley. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it, and she'll shoot one more at the line. She'll be shooting her first free throw of the game. And the Dream making a change here. And the free throw, no good.
A first-round pick by Atlanta in 2013. Alex Bentley actually made her first All-Star game with Connecticut in 2015, averaging nearly 15 points per game that season.
And a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half. Dream out in front, leading by a point. And we will see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball in just a bit. And it's been a back-and-forth game with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter getting started here. Allie Quigley with a strong contribution so far in this one.
He has that slasher mentality, and we really saw evidence of it in the first half. She got to the rim again and again and kept on scoring.
Look, we know that she's got that great first step, but she must have woken up on the right side of the bed today because she looks fast out there.
Start of the third quarter here after a closely contested first half. The Sky trail. Vandersloot outside. Outside Quigley. For the lead. And the layup is good.
You know, it's so important for Quigley to score inside. Why? Scoring close to the hoop opens up her long-range game.
Now here's Montgomery. Pass to Hayes. Reeland. Here's McCautry. Offensive board. Misses from close range.
That's the way you want to defend. Nice job there.
Always so important to have that strong interior defense.
Parker. And there's 2 points. Work on the glass, paying off that time.
A relentless attitude. Parker commits herself to the boards whenever she's on the court.
Pass to Hayes. And no good. Some solid defense from Cheyenne Parker.
They've yet to hit. A slow start to the second half.
And the Atlanta Dream get their wins through their defense. You know, force a lot of turnovers with the pressure they put on, and they just do a great job of closing out on shooters and challenging every shot.
Now here's Montgomery. Here's Freeland. And she battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket.
An agile forward who uses great leaping ability to swallow rebounds. Freeland is quick off the ground.
Quigley with it. She's guarded by Hayes. Pass to Vandersloot. Elizabeth Williams pulls it in. And with the defense of the Dream, some great shot blocking as well.
Freeland and Williams, both fantastic rim protectors. The whole group does a good job of getting a hand up on every attempt. Atlanta has built their team around defense.
Now here's Quigley. 13 points in this game. Parker, Freeland defending. Cheyenne Parker drives in. And the basket is good.
They've been getting it inside at every opportunity, and they're getting excellent results.
You know, that's a winning formula, pounding the ball down low, being aggressive. You know, they're being very assertive offensively.
McCautry with it, covered by DeShields. Outside Hayes, just 4 to shoot. For the tie. Chicago with the rebound.
Those have been some terrible shot choices, Blake. That was not good at all.
Here's Vandersloot. Banked in off the glass.
This just doesn't look like the same team defensively we saw in the first half. No intensity out there.
Pass to Breland. McCautry. Now here is Hayes. Back to Williams. Rejected by Cheyenne Parker.
Well, long arms and top-notch awareness make Parker the quality shot blocker she is.
Chicago leading. Allie Quigley drives in. Vandersloot outside. Here's the teardrop. And she was fouled in the act of shooting, an opportunity for a 3-point play.
They're going on a nice little run here.
And getting to the rack has been the key. They're getting point-blank looks time and time again.
Montgomery. And
and they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off. They got to score.
McCautry outside. Teardrop shot, and she sinks the layup.
Knifing through defenses on a regular basis, McCautry's got a good first step and plays in control.
Now here's Vandersloot.
9 points in the game.
Pass to Parker, to Shields. 5 on the clock. Ball's knocked loose. Stolen by Jessica Breland. Here's Hayes. That's good, and so Renee Montgomery with the assist.
I don't think hustle is really ever in question with Hayes because her energy is pretty much always fully charged.
Now here's Vandersloot. A rebound by Montgomery.
The defense was ready for her, got a hand in her face, and made that one much tougher.
And that's something that every team needs, rugged interior defense to just make your opponent think twice about coming down the lane.
After winning a couple national titles at Connecticut, Tiffany Hayes was kind of a forgotten player. Picked in the second round of the 2012 draft. Understandably, she was in the shadow of greats like Maya Moore and Tina Charles.
It's been fun to watch the blossoming of Hayes, making a name for herself.
Well, Blake, you want to know what's been most impressive to me about Hayes? It's that she improved her scoring average in each of her first 7 years in the league. To me, that just speaks to her incredible dedication to the craft of playing basketball.
And the first one falls for her.
Well, with a minutes increase in 2018, Parker rose to the occasion with increased output across the board.
And that one goes in, 2 from the line that time. Atlanta trailing here. Now Bentley. She has 7. Sykes outside. So she gets the whistle. Contact on the way up. 2 shots. Next.
For a guard, Sykes isn't a great foul shooter, and she's really hard to guard. So sending her to the line might be a good idea.
And she'll take her 3rd and 4th free throw shots of the night.
Shooting 2.
And the first one at the line is good.
The 4th overall pick by Atlanta in 2017. Brittany Sykes has been brought in to do one thing, score, and she has provided a punch.
And so she's able to get 1 of 2. To the paint. Here's Williams. Misses and close. Atlanta with the ball. Pass to Bentley. Back to Sykes. Breland. Now Bentley. 6 on the shot clock. For the tie. Not gonna go that time. Here's Samuelson. Pass to Lavender. That shot off the mark. Now the Dream take it the other way. Right side, Bentley. Back to Sykes. Breland. Bentley with the ball. Here's Billings. No good on the shot. A bit long that time. Down low.
Endor
gets the bucket and the foul.
It's on Brittany Sykes.
Great ball movement to the open player. Samuelson with her head on a swivel.
The Dream making a switch here.
Well, guys, I think Katie Lou Samuelson is certainly a player who competes with a chip on her shoulder. Growing up as the youngest sibling with two sisters who played collegiate basketball, she was determined to be the best of the three.
Here's Coffey. Outside, Bentley. Pass to Coffey.
From beyond the arc, but they get it back.
Here's Billings.
So the whistle blows on the shot. Two free throws for the contact there.
And Samuelson, not a player you have to fire up before games. Why is that, Brian?
Well, my name's Tim. We've only done a million games together, but anyway, she's a fearless as they come. I mean, Katie Lou has played in some big-time games, played through pain.
Take a break.
No matter
break.
What, Samuelson Two wants shots. To be there for her team. That's the mentality that every rookie in the league should have.
The first free throw is good. And she makes both free throws. Chicago with the ball. A 4-point game.
Don't give her space.
Williams. Pass to Samuelson. Endor. She's guarded by Williams. Five to shoot. Over Sykes. Dream with the rebound.
She can't get anything to drop. And the way she's going, it's probably not something she should try to shoot her way out of.
And I'm sure her teammates would agree with that. You know, the last thing they want to see her doing is shooting it more.
Now here's Williams. She's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Pass to Endor. Lavender up top. That shot off. And the Dream going the other way now. Here's Billings. It's hauled in by Williams. Over to the left wing. Pass to Lavender. Williams. Tried to bank it in, but he misses.
She hasn't made an impact from the field, but the team is getting it done. She owes them big time.
Sykes with the bucket.
Even though she's more of a scoring guard, Bentley's basketball IQ helped her find the open teammate.
Now here's Williams. Pass to Samuelson. Lavender. Here's Copper. It's hauled in by Williams. It's Brittany Sykes on the wing. That misses. Had a chance to tie it there. Here's Copper. She has five. Looking to end the drought. And that's 2 points on the layup. The Dream on offense. Trailing by four. Pass to Sykes. Billings. Knocked away. Williams with the steal. 3 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. And here is Sykes. 7 points in the game.
from past the arc.
Oh, no good.
And we've reached the end of the third.
It's the Sky
up by six. And time for a short break. Stay right where you are. The fourth quarter is coming up next. And a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
Slice the D wide open with this feed. They really had no chance to prevent this basket.
Yeah, it was a great read of the defensive setup and also wonderful anticipation of the movement of her teammates before the pass.
We welcome you back to what has been a good one here as we get into the fourth quarter. Bentley with the ball. Billings. She's guarded by Lavender. Outside, Bentley. Shot clock at five. They get it again. A shot by Billings. No good.
Nice work there to contest the finish inside.
Yeah, they got the shot they wanted, but her defense laid waste to those plans.
Now here's Williams, right wing. Here's Samuelson. Pass to Vandersloot. Shoots the three. The putback. She hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Great job of crashing the offensive glass. Now she stayed with it for some hard-nosed, tough basketball.
Here's Billings. Now Bentley. Left side, Williams. The 8-footer, and down it goes. 2 points.
Well, this is where she makes her money, in the paint. Williams can score many different ways down low.
About a minute and a half through the fourth quarter now. It's Gabby Williams on the wing. She's guarded by Sykes. Pass to Vandersloot. Back to Lavender. Williams. And the defense really pressing up on her and made it a tough shot. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, it's been a long time without a bucket. Focus.
Inside. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass.
You can see why she has the best career assist average in WNBA history. Vandersloot, she really just sets up open shots, leads the easy points.
Here's Billings. McCautry up top. From the elbow, and there it is.
Showing good confidence as a scorer, McCautry has a polished mid-range game. And she's still getting better.
Timeout called the Sky.
Started.
I continue to be impressed with McCautry's defense. Now, she moves her feet well to stay in front of opponents. And with her active hands, she's able to make a lot of steals.
Dream making a switch here. Just over 2.5 minutes played now. Final quarter of regulation. Quigley, she's guarded by Hayes.
Pass to Vandersloot. Parker. Another shot. Jessica Breland with some nice D.
If only she can improve on what's been a shaky day for her, they could really stretch this lead out, don't you think?
Yep, count it.
Well, after she had a tough first half, it's been a different story since the break.
On the wing, Allie Quigley. She's guarded by Hayes. Here's to Shields. And once again, off the mark by Chicago. Breland covered by DeShields. Breland misses.
And terrific defense at the rim, got right in her path.
And you know they'll be worrying about her next time they take it inside, too. And really, that's what great defenders will do to you.
Now here is Dolson. Up top, Vandersloot. Clock at 6. Pass to Parker. Jessica Breland with some nice D.
Well, thus far, they managed to overcome an off game from her offensively.
And it's Renee Montgomery penetrating. Breland misses. Chicago in the lead. And here's Quigley. Montgomery covering. And it's Dolson missing. Left side, Hayes. And she banks in the layup.
I'm such a fan of the pace and the rhythm that Hayes plays with. I mean, she can get herself going in no time.
Now here's Vandersloot. Pass to Parker. DeShields with it. Breland defending. DeShields with it. Breland on her. And she'll shoot free throws. Clearly fouled on the shot that time. The whistle blows. And Atlanta gets called for the foul.
Well, Diamond DeShields is part of an incredible family of athletes. Of course, her dad and brother, both professional baseball players. Can you even imagine the games of pickup in their backyard?
And the first one falls for her. Well, the DeShields family is stacked athletically. You can't forget about their mom, Tisha.
Yeah, Tisha was an All-American in track at Tennessee. When you watch Diamond play, you can see how confident and tough she is. Signs of someone from an elite family of athletes.
So she gets them both.
Tim, can you believe the job they're doing at the foul line since halftime? They've been perfect.
Brian, I almost can't believe this. As cool as can be, great focus, great efficiency. That's how they've built this lead.
The right way.
Now here is McCautry. Back to Breland. Stolen by DeShields. Right side Parker. Knocked away. It's stolen by Elizabeth Williams. Here's Montgomery. Hayes. Great positioning on the putback.
A gritty player who gives 110% effort whenever she's out on the court. Hayes just does not quit.
Now here's DeShields. Dolson, she's guarded by Williams. Here's Vandersloot. That's all good, and that's her fifth basket of the game. She's shooting 5-for-11 now.
She's got a great read of where that miss was going, and that enabled her to be the first player to it and get the put back.
Hayes with it, and Parker picks her up defensively. Tosses it up. McCautry no good. On offense, here the Sky. They lead by 4. Yep, that goes.
Well, it's nice to see DeShields utilize not just her athleticism, but body control in her efforts to score points.
Now here's Montgomery. Tiffany Hayes on the wing. Six on the shot clock. Tiffany Hayes double team. Pass to McCautry. Yes, and a nice assist from Tiffany Hayes.
She's starting to turn it on now after a slow start.
And here's Parker. Quigley with it.
Now here's DeShields. She's guarded by Williams. Foul call that time on the way up, and that'll give her two chances at the free throw line. It's going to go on Elizabeth Williams.
At the line for your Chicago Sky, Diamond DeShields taking two shots.
Two shots.
And the first one drops.
Third pick in the 2018 WNBA draft. DeShields went on to have a terrific rookie campaign.
And good on the second, so she makes both. Here's Montgomery. Tipped away. Outside Hayes. Outside Williams. Pass to Montgomery. Williams. Tries again. And a foul called on the shot. Got her on the way up that time, so she'll shoot two.
Good idea to just foul Williams. She's an average free throw shooter. Don't give her easy looks.
Elizabeth Williams. Two shots.
Shooting two.
The first one falls.
One of their problems in the first half was their shoddy work at the free throw line. They needed to fix that, and they've been much better since halftime.
Second free throw, no good.
Drafted in the top five in the 2015 draft by Connecticut, Elizabeth Williams really struggled as a rookie, but after a change of scenery getting traded to Atlanta, she was the 2016 WNBA Most Improved Player.
Now here is McCautry. And she uses the glass on the layup.
You can't let McCautry get going downhill if you're the defense. She's too smart and too effective when doing so.
Here's Parker. Outside Quigley. Outside to Shields. Gets a very good look and converts.
A hard worker who understands the nuances of the game. DeShields loves to learn and is comfortable running the pick and roll.
Now here is McCautry. Takes the 13-footer. The shot, no good. The Sky go the other way with it. Now here's Vandersloot. Pass to Dolson. Over Montgomery. Dolson's shot's good.
Time out.
It's really a sign of a great player. Doesn't let a bump here, contact there. Stopper. Nice job by Dolson.
And the dream call time here. present our Jordan player of the game, Diamond DeShields.
Well, you want to talk about aggressive? She's been determined to take it to the hole every chance she gets. And even in the face of shot blockers, she's been able to finish strong.
Not sure if they expected her to perform like this today, but they sure needed it. After back-to-back losses, she did not want to drop a third straight game.
Now here is McCautry. Breland outside. Pass to Hayes. Now Williams, guarded by Quigley. Williams can't get it to go.
Excellent interior D right there to force the miss.
Yeah, and unlike you, Tim, her defensive ability is a huge factor, no doubt about it.
Here's Vandersloot, covered by McCautry. Quigley with it. To the inside. Here's Vandersloot. That one falls, coming off Stephanie Dolson's feed.
Terrific run to put this ballgame away.
And now let's see just how much longer they keep that foot on the accelerator.
They got to keep it on the accelerator to the finish line.
Now here is McCautry. Pass to Williams. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down.
What movement from Williams. She's dangerous in the pick and roll going to the hoop.
And they can just sit on the ball here.
Enjoy it. They've earned the win.
No doubt. Now here's DeShields, covered by McCautry. Now DeShields. No problem for Chicago as they get the win. And some good competition, but the hometown advantage and their ability to stay focused, I think, made the difference.
You got to defend your home floor, and they really seem to revel in confidence. This is what they came out to do here.
That'll do it for our broadcast, everyone.